Let's take a look at this problem in Reddit. There is a main conical shell with a boss here. The idea is to join this boss to the conical shell with a rib. When I looked at this problem, my first instinct was to use a rib or web command. Before we do that, let's try using the extrude command, as explained in the original post, and see where that leads us. The user who posted this problem attempted to make an extrude using this profile. Due to the conical nature of this face, we will be left with an excess of material here. We can select this face and simply press the delete key. Fusion is smart enough to know what we are trying to achieve here and automatically heals the surface. Although this is pretty convenient, we do want to try to avoid doing this as it is not really parametric. There was a suggestion to use the extend to object option during the extrude command. In the extrude command, for extend type, select to object. And select this face. We get an error that says that the profile falls outside of the boundary of the selected face. If we look at the top-down view, we can see that the profile extends beyond the selected face. This is a common problem when working with the Extend to Object option. Choosing the Adjacent Faces option does not resolve this. Let's try using the web command. Begin a sketch on this face. And sketch a single line. The web command works in a similar way to the thin extrude and does not require closed profiles. Go to Create, Web. Select the sketch line as a profile. For extend type, select Tool Next. Check on the Extended Curves option. This is so that you would extrapolate up to the conical face. Adjust the thickness. It does extend nicely up to the conical face without producing any excess on the other side. However, it goes through the boss. The web command tends to struggle in a multi-body environment. The boss in this case is a separate body. The command does not seem to be able to recognize the existence of the boss. Let's take a look at a scenario where the cone has a base. In this case, the boss is attached to the cone as a single body. Let's repeat the same steps to create the web. In this case, the command recognizes the existence of the boss and does not go beyond the boss. If you want to use this method, you will need to cut off the base at the end. Let's try using the rib command. For the rib command, we would have to perform the sketch on the front plane. We need to create anchor points for the sketch line. go to Create, Project Include, Intersect. Select these two edges and confirm. This creates two points that are a result of the intersection between the current sketch plane and these two edges. Sketch a line to join these two points. Go to Create, Rip. Select the sketch line as a profile. For Extend Type, select Tool Next. Adjust the thickness. Similar to the Web command, the Rip command struggles in a multi-body environment. Again, if we repeat the same steps with the case where the cone had a base, you can create the rip successfully. So far, we have seen the challenges involved in using the Extrude, Web, and Rip commands. And there does not seem to be a good solution. In this particular design, there is actually quite an elegant way of doing this using the Web command. The important thing to take note here is that the Web command can also be used for creating bosses. Let's start without the boss. Perform a sketch on this face. This will simply be a circle with a line that joins to the edge of the cone. Begin the web command. Select the circle and the line. Set Extend Type to Next and check on the Extend Curves option. Adjust the thickness. This gives us exactly what we need. The rim extrapolates up to the conical face without any excess on the other side. At the same time, it conforms to the cylindrical face of the boss. One thing to take note here is that this method works only if the required boss thickness and the rib thickness are the same.